Hi guys, today our question is a voltage V of t is equal to 141.4 sin omega t is applied to a circuit given below. The circuit dissipates 450 watts at lagging power factor. Power factor is lagging. When ammeter reads 6 amps, calculate the circuit parameters. Here it was given that ammeter reads 6 amperes. See, let us consider this is the current I. I is dividing into two parts. Let us say this is I1 and this one is, let us say, I2. Okay, again I1 plus I2. The current I will flow through the circuit like this. Okay, this parallel combination is connected in series with this one. Here it is R1 plus X1 in the sense entire this combination will be Z1, this combination will be Z1, and now this combination will become Z2. Okay, so what we have to do is we have to find the circuit parameters, this X2, this R1 and this X1 we have to find. So first of all, we will find what is Z2. Z2 is equal to R2 plus JX2. Am I correct or not? JX2. So from that we can write Z2 is equal to root over R2 square plus X2 square. Given R2 is equal to how much it is? It is 10 ohms. And we have to find what is X2. But what about Z2? Z2 is equal to, impedance is defined as the ratio of voltage to current, and here the voltage is 100, current is 6 amperes. That is, Z2 is equal to 16.66 ohms. Okay, so now we can find X2 by is equal to root over R2 square minus, sorry, it is root over Z2 square minus, see here, see, it is root over Z2 square minus R2 square. So what is Z2 square? Z2 square is equal to 16.66 whole square minus R2 square in the sense. R2 is 10 ohms, 10 into 10, 100. So root of this one, and finally by solving, we'll get X2 is equal to 13.33 ohms. What is the value of this X2? It is 13.33 ohms. Okay. So now the applied voltage. What is the applied voltage? V of t is equal to 141.4 sin omega t. Okay. So from that, what we have to find is we have to find VRMS. VRMS is equal to Vm by root 2. VRMS is equal to Vm by root 2. Now see here. So VRMS, let us say VRMS is equal to Vm 141.4 Vm by root 2. Now that VRMS is equal to 100 ohms. VRMS is equal to 100 ohms. And given that power dissipated in the circuit is 450 watts. Power dissipated by the circuit is 450 watts. So we can write that one as VI cos phi is equal to 450 watts. Am I correct or not? Power is VI cos phi, that is 450 watts. What is V? V is equal to 100. And what is I? It is 6 cos phi into sorry, which is equal to 450 watts. Now from that we can find cos phi. Cos phi is equal to 450 by 100 into 6, it is 600. 600 will get 0.75. Whenever cos phi is equal to 0.75, then phi is equal to cos inverse of 0.75. It will be equal to how much it is? 41.4 degrees. What is this 41.4 degrees? It is the power factor, and it was given that this power factor is a lagging one. Okay, lagging power factor. This power factor is a lagging power factor. Now current I is equal to we can write 6 at an angle minus 41.4 degrees. 6 at an angle minus 41.4 degrees. See, now we will find the voltage across Z2. Okay? Now what we'll do is we'll find the voltage across Z2. See, voltage across Z2 in the sense that is V across what is Z2? Z2 is equal to 10 plus J 13.33 ohms. Okay, so voltage across this combination, voltage across this combination, which is equal to V is equal to I into R. V is equal to I into R. Now V is equal to what is I? I is 6 at an angle minus 41.4 degrees. 6 at an angle minus 141.4 degrees into, and converting this in, into rectangular form, will get 16.66 at an angle 53.12. What is this? This one is we can say Z. So now voltage across this combination is V is equal to I into Z. What is Z? 16.66 at an angle 53.12. Okay. Now on simplifying, we'll get voltage is equal to 100 at an angle 11.7 degrees. So the voltage across Z2 is 100 at an angle 11.7 degrees. Okay, so after that we'll find the voltage across this parallel branch. We'll find the voltage across this combination. Okay, so how we will find that is V is equal to what is the RMS voltage? 100 at an angle 0 degrees, 100 at an angle 0 degrees minus 100 at an angle 11.7 degrees. 100 at an angle 11.7 degrees. Now the voltage across this parallel combination will be V1 is equal to 20.38 at an angle minus 84.08 degrees. Minus 84.08 degrees. Now with this data we'll find the current across J20 minus J20 ohms, that is we'll find I2, this current. Okay, so I2 is equal to, I is equal to V by Z, that is V. What is V? V is 20.38 at an angle minus 84.08 by impedance minus J20, in the sense it is 20 at an angle minus 90 degrees. Okay, 20 at an angle minus 90 degrees. Then the current I2 will be, I2 is equal to 1.02 at an angle 5.92 degrees. This is the current across minus J20 reactants. Minus J20 reactants. Now the current in
R1 minus JX1, that is I1, I1 is given by, it is equal to I, 6 at an angle, minus 41.4, minus 41.4, minus how much it is? By substituting the I2 from the total current, we will get the current flowing through that branch, 1.02 at an angle, 5.92 degrees, then the current I1 will be 5.36 at an angle minus 49.39 degrees. Okay, so the current across R1 plus JX1 is 5.36 at an angle minus 49.39 degrees at an angle minus 49.39 degrees. Okay, so now we'll find impedance Z1. Z1 in the sense a combination of R1 plus X1. The impedance Z1 is given by V1 by I1. V1 by I1. What is V1? 20.38 at an angle minus 84.08 degrees by I1. I1 is 5.36 at an angle minus 49.39 degrees. Okay, so from that we can find Z1 is equal to 3.8 minus 34.69 degrees. So it is, while converting this one into A plus IB form, we'll get 3.12 minus 2.16, that is Z1 is equal to R1 plus JX1, R1 plus JX1. So from that R1 is equal to 3.12 and X1 is equal to how much it is? 2.16 ohms. Okay, so these are the unknown parameters R1 and X1, and here we found X2. Okay, these are the unknown parameters. Okay, so thank you.